Gesicht, der Hut flog mir vom Kopfe, ich wendete mich nicht. Nun bin ich manche Stunde entfernt von jenem Ort, und immer hör ich's rauschen, du fändest Ruhe dort. Nun bin ich manche Stunde entfernt von jenem Ort, und immer hör ich's rauschen, du fändest Ruhe dort, du fändest Ruhe dort.
Where do you feel most at home? Of all the places in the world, of all the cities, countries, parks, gardens, palaces maybe for some, of all the places in the world, where do you feel most at home? This is a question that's running through my mind today, because the word of today is Heimat, home. Homeland. And this is a very beautiful word, and a word that peppers German romantic poetry and Schubert songs. This feeling of love and self-identification with a place or one's homeland. If I had to say where I feel most at home, I would probably say Kensington Gardens. It's a place I've known like my whole life, and I've had so many different experiences of being there as a child, playing with friends, being there after school as a teenager. I cycle to and fro it almost every day. This evening when I go to rehearsals at the Colosseum in Covent Garden, I'll be cycling through it. Running through it with my dog, going on walks, walking to town. It's just a place I love. I feel so comfortable. I kind of know it inside out, and it stimulates my thoughts. And yeah, I just feel like I can move through it so kind of effortlessly. I want to share with you some thoughts about Heimat. And firstly, in Der Lindenbaum, which is the fifth song of Schubert's Winterreise, Winter Journey, the wanderer encounters this linden tree, and it conjures up all sorts of memories for him, and he remembers all of the times that he's talked about his, you know, pains and the joys of love, sitting underneath this tree, confiding in it, and dreaming and sleeping in its shade. And then in the middle part of the song, the linden tree takes on an almost human, supernatural character, where the branches, the rustling branches, almost call out to him, saying, "Come to me, my friend, here you shall find rest." And the cold wind starts to blow, and his hat falls off his head, and the kind of this sort of tumultuous, spooky nature is evoked by Schubert's music. And then in the end, the wind settles, and there's a kind of returning to this kind of more serene state. And the wanderer, who is now many hours away from the linden tree, he's gone, continued on his adventure, but he can still hear the rustling of that linden tree, and can hear the linden tree's voice saying, "There you shall find rest." So the first idea I just want to throw out is that, to a certain extent, the paradoxical idea of Heimat and homeland is that you only feel it most palpably, most strongly, when you're removed from that place. I guess the notion of being homesick, but one feels the love of home when one's taken away from home, or one's kind of so far removed from it. So that's something I quite liked about the idea that's evoked in Der Lindenbaum, is being the wanderer so far removed from the linden tree, but can so vividly recall and capture that mood and the time that he was there with the linden tree. It's still very much a part of him and is inside him. Now I want to share with you a poem from the Manyoshu, which translates as a collection of a myriad leaves, and is basically a collection of poetry. It's considered one of the earliest anthologies of Japanese poetry, so you're going back to sort of 8th century Japan. And I want to kind of make a connection between Der Lindenbaum and Schubert's Heimat, home, loving sort of theme. And I want to read from you a poem in the Manyoshu, which is titled "Wishing for Pearls to Send to His Home in the Capital." "Of those abalone pearls that Suzu's fishermaids dive for, crossing over, I hear, to the holy isle of the sea, would I had many, even 500, to my dear loving wife, who ever since we parted sleeves must be sighing after me, counting the weary days and months, passing the nights in a half-empty bed, and forbearing to comb her morning hair, to her I'd pack and send them, saying, just to comfort you, darling, make a garland of these pearls, threading them together with orange blossoms and the sweet flag flowers of June, when the cuckoo comes to sing. How I wish to send home to my love a package of those lucent pearls, that she might string them together with orange blossoms and sweet flag flowers. Oh, for the abalone pearls they dive for, I hear, crossing over to the holy isle of the sea, I would pack and send them home. Oh, for the lucent pearls from the holy isle of the sea, that I might send them to my love, to comfort her heart. How happy should I be, were there a fishermaid to give me those shining pearls by the hundred, scooping them up in her hands." So the title, "Wishing for Pearls to send to His Home in the Capital." I love this poem, and I wanted to read it because, again, you feel palpably, clearly this man is separated from his lover, from his wife, and from his capital, and from his home. And he longs for these pearls, he's wishing for them, he's praying for these abalone pearls, which are these lucent pearls that there are specific fishermaids who dived down to the very depths of the ocean and would collect these pearls. They were very precious and very beautiful. And he's wishing for these pearls that he can bring them home, send them home to his wife, and that she can make some sort of garland out of these pearls together with orange blossoms. So this longing for home and all of the kind of associations of home, his wife is part of that longing for his home. And it's just a very powerful and evocative image, and something that I think is a through line. It's a running thread of a lot of Japanese poetry and literature, and also the romantic German, Germanic poetry and songs that Schubert explored throughout his life. So, Heimat, Der Lindenbaum, Manyosho poetry, and the longing for home. Where is the place you most feel at home?